Happy morning, students. Welcome to Grade 10 Mathematics online class. Okay, have you all done the homework that I given in the last class? That is 5 progress check problem and some other problems. No, Euclid's division algorithm. There are 2 problems. Have you done? Okay. Let's see the continuation of chapter 2, numbers and sequence. Okay, let's listen to the class now. Okay, let's see the progress check answer for the first problem. A is equal to 13, B is equal to 3, A is equal to BQ plus R. So, 13 we can write it as 3 into 4, that is 12 plus 1, 13. So, quotient is 4 and the remainder is 1. For the second question, A is equal to 18, B is equal to 4. 18 can be represented as 4 fours are 16 plus 2. So, quotient is 4 and remainder is 2. Check the remainder is positive number only. Here, the divisor, the remainder should be less than the divisor. The divisor is 3. So, the remainder is 1, less than, correct only. So, here the divisor is 4 and the remainder is 2. So, that also correct. It should be less than b, less than modulus of b. So, here b is minus 4, modulus of b is 4, the remainder is 1. So, less than that. So, correct. So, minus 4 into minus 5 is 20, 20 plus 1, 21. So, quotient is minus 5 and the remainder is 1. See the fourth question. A is equal to minus 32, B is equal to minus 12. So, here minus 12 into 3. That means minus 36 will come plus 4. So, minus 32. Quotient is 3, remainder is 4. Got it, students? Here the modulus of B is 12, no? So, the modulus value when we are taking 12, the remainder is less than that. So, it is correct. So, we should check. Minus 31 is equal. The number should be come correctly. Minus 31 is equal to 7 into minus 5. Minus 35 plus 4 is minus 31. The remainder is 4, which is less than 7. So, it is correct. Check the answer that you have written with this. Got it, students? Shall we move for the exercise problems in 2.1? Okay, let's listen. Listen, dear students. Exercise 2.1, first question. Find all positive integers when divided by 3 leaves the remainder 2. Okay? So, here we can use Euclid's division lemma for finding this by Euclid's division lemma. What is the concept? A is equal to BQ plus R, where 0 less than or equal to or less than. Here all positive integers, no? So, we can select less than B only. Okay. So, here find all positive integers. A value we need to find when divided by B. So, A is equal to divided by B. This is the divisor. So, 3. Q value we don't know. Q plus remainder is 2. So, we need to find all the values. Okay. Where Q is equal to, here find all positive integers only. So, here Q value we need to put 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, it goes on. So, when Q is equal to 0, we need to find the value of A. A is equal to 3 into 0 plus 2, which is equal to 0 plus 2, which is equal to 2. Got it? Then, when Q is equal to 1, A is equal to 3 into 1 plus 2. So, 3 plus 2, that is 5. Got it, students? Then, when Q is equal to 2, A is equal to 3 into 2 plus 2, which is equal to 6 plus 2. Here, 8. So, when Q is equal to 3, A is equal to 3 into 3 plus 2. So, 9 plus 2, that is 11. So, here so many values we are getting, no? So, the answer is, therefore, the required numbers are, what are the numbers? When placing 0, we are getting 2. When putting 1, we are getting 5. When putting 2, we are getting 8. When getting 3, we are getting 11. And 4, we are getting another number. 5, we will get another number. So, the number, the process will go on and on. So, you can put etc. Okay, it is very important. You need to put etc. There are so many numbers will come. See, we can check whether our answer is correct or wrong. Here, when 2 is divided by 3, we need to get the remainder 2. So, how it is possible? 2 when we divided by 3, 0, 3s are 0, the remainder is 2, correct? So, 5 when we divided by 3, 1, 3 is 3, the remainder is 2. So, 8 when we divided by 3, 3, 2s are 6, the remainder is 2. 11 when we divided by 3, 3, 3s are 9, the remainder is 2. So, in all these cases, when we divide by 3, we are getting the remainders 2. That only they asked. Find all positive integers when divided by 3, leaving the remainder 2. So, these are the answers. When we divided by 2, we are getting the 2 as remainder. So, by Euclid's division lemma, first write the formula. After that, write the format. Here, writing the format is very, very important. A is equal to B. B is divisor. No. So, when divided by 3, that is the divisor. So, 3. So, here question we don't know. We are going to find. Plus, remainder is 2. In that format, we need to find this. Got it, students? Shall we move for the next question? Listen, dear students. Exercise 2.1. Second question. A man has 532 flower pots. He wants to arrange them in rows such that each row contains 21 flower pots. So, totally he has 532 flower pots. So, here in one row, how many flower pots we need to keep? 21 flower pots. Find the number of completed rows and how many flower pots are left over. This is same as which problem? That cake problem. So, this question you need to do as homework. So, what is today's homework? Exercise 2.1. Mark the homework problems now itself. Exercise 2.1. Second problem. And here also one problem. There are two problems remaining. No. Sixth Roman. Third and fourth. Remaining problems we can see now. Listen here. Using the divisions Euclid's division algorithm to find the HCF of. First two problems already you did in the previous class itself. Homework. So, next 3 and 4, today's homework. Here, normal method. Here, 3 numbers, how will you find? Finding the first two numbers HCF. After that, by getting that answer, you need to find the HCF of that answer and the third number. Got it, students? Okay. Now, write the third question. Okay, listen, dear students. Prove that the product of two consecutive positive integers is divisible by 2. Let's do practically by applying some numbers. We need to prove the product of two consecutive positive integers. What is the meaning of consecutive? What is the next number? Consecutive means next number. Say 3 consecutive numbers after 5. What are the 3 numbers? 6, 7, 8. That are the consecutive numbers after 5. Similarly, here we need to take two positive integers, consecutive positive integers, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 11, 12. That way, two positive numbers, integers we need to take. That number should be consecutive. Next numbers. That two numbers we need to take product. Okay, product means multiplication. So, whenever we are taking product, that number is surely divisible by 2. That is the thing we need to prove. Okay, let's do practically here. Some numbers. I am taking 2 positive integers. Consecutive positive integers. So, 5 and 6 I am taking. These 2 are positive integers. It is consecutive. Because next numbers, 5 and 6. I am going to product this. 5 into 6, 30. Is it divisible by 2? Yes. So, there is a general rule. Prove that the product of 2 consecutive positive integers, surely it is divisible by 2. 30 is divisible by 2, correct? Because 30 when dividing by 2, 15 times we are getting the remainder is 0. So, it is divisible by 2. Let's we check for another number, another two numbers. You are wish, you can check. You will surely get this. Okay? Positive integers. Any two positive integers you need to take. So, two positive integers. Shall we, two digit number shall we take? 21 and 22. So, 21 and 22, there are two positive integers. Now, we are going to take the product. So, 22 into 21. So, 2, 2, 4 and 4 and 2, 6, 4. So, 462 is the required answer. Whether it is divisible by 2? Yes. When we cancel this, we are getting without remainder. 2, 3, 1. Yes, it is possible to divisible by 2. So, practically we did. The concept okay? So now we are going to do by considering variables. Prove that the product of two consecutive positive integers is divisible by 2. Here the first number I took is odd number. Here also odd number. If we select on even number, how it will be? So I am selecting on even number first, 8. Next consecutive number surely will be a odd number. First even number, next odd number. Here first odd number, next even number. Both the cases we need to check. So first I am selecting on even number. What is the consecutive even next positive integer? 9. When multiplying this, I am getting 72. It is divisible by 2. Correct, Chandli, no? So first, case 1. Let the first number be, two numbers are there, no, product of two consecutive positive integers. So let the first number be, what will be the first number? First number be even number. Even number. Let the first number be even. That is, even number, what is the general format? 2k. 2k is always even because it is a multiple of 2. Therefore, the next number is, what is the second number? The next number is surely odd. What is the next number? Next number is odd. No need to write. The next number is, what is the next number of 2k? 2k plus 1. That is the concept. Okay. First number, it is even. And here that is 2k. And the next number of this, we need to add 1. So 2k plus 1. Now we are going to take the product. So what is the product? Product is 2k into 2k plus 1. Product, correct? 2k into 2k plus 1. Now I am splitting this. 2 into k into 2k plus 1. And separated into 3 terms. Got it, students? 3 terms. Now, 2 into, the same thing only, k into 2k plus 1. Now see, it is the multiple of 2. All the multiples of 2 are surely divisible by 2. So since it is a multiple of 2, it is divisible by 2. Since it is the multiple of 2, it is divisible by 2. Sketch gets over. Okay. Divisible by 2. Got it, students? Is the writing clear? Have you all got the point? Case 1 only over. Then one more case there is. So prove that the product of two consecutive positive integers is divisible by 2. First case, the first number be even. So what will be the next number? 2k plus 1. So product is, we need to take the product, just separated like this. Multiplication symbol. Both the here 3 terms are there. No, 2 1 term. K, then 2k plus 1. So it is a multiple of this. So, since it is a multiple of 2, it is divisible by 2. That's all the concept. Let's see the case 2. Okay, what is case 2? Let the first number be, there we took even number. Here, first number be, we are taking odd. What is the format of odd? 2k plus 1. It is the format for odd. Therefore, what is the next number? The next number is equal to, consecutive numbers we need to take. So, consecutive number, when we find it, we need to add 1. So, 2k plus 1 plus 1, which is equal to 2k plus 2. Got it? So, case 2, first number is odd. We select the odd number. 2k plus 1 is the general format for odd number. The next number is 2k plus 1 plus 1. Because the next number, addition 1. So, 2k plus 2. Now, we are going to take the product. What is the product? 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 1. 2k plus 2. Which is equal to 2k plus 1 into here. What is the common term? 2 is common. So 2 when we are taking outside, k plus 1. Which is equal to 2 into 2k plus 1 into k plus 1. So here also it is the multiple of 2. So since it is the multiple of 2, it is divisible by 2. That's divisible by 2. So hence, proved. So both cases we proved. In the first case, we selected the first number is even and the next number is 2k plus 1. And here the second case, the first number is odd and the next number is 2k plus 1 plus 1, consecutive numbers. And the last itself we are getting two multiples of 2. Multiple of 2 means surely it is divisible by 2. That's all the concept. Okay. Shall we move on to the fourth problem now? Listen dear students, fourth question. When the positive integers a, b and c are divided by 13, the respective remainders are 9, 7 and 10. Show that a plus b plus c is divisible by 13. Got it? So here also we are going to use the Euclid's division lemma. What is the first thing? When a is divided by 13, so by Euclid's division lemma, we know a is equal to bq plus r. This is the general format, correct? But given when a is the positive integer, when the positive integer a is divided by 13. So what is the divisor? 13. So we are mentioning q. What is the remainder? The remainder is 9. So 9. Got it? So a is equal to 13. When divided by 13, that is the divisor. So q as it is, coefficient we don't know. Plus remainder is 9. Respective remainders. So for A, the remainder is 9. B, the remainder is 7. C, the remainder is 10 when divided by 13. So this is the first case given. Then what is the next one given? B is divided by 13. So B is divided by 13. Another coefficient will come. So let it be Q1 and Q2. We couldn't get the same coefficient. So we need to vary it by mentioning Q1 and Q2 plus, what is the remainder, respective reminders next one? 7. So 7 we need to mention like this. Then see, when positive integer C is divided by, so C is equal to, when divided by 13, the same divisor only, 13, we will get different coefficient. So that is Q3 plus, what is the remainder? 10. It is the remainder. This three concept first itself you need to write. Okay students, then show that we need to prove a plus b plus c is divisible by 13. This is the thing we need to prove. So to prove a plus b plus c is divisible by 13. So a plus b plus c is equal to, what is the value of a? 13 q1 plus 9. What is the value of b? 13 q2 plus 7. What is c? 13 q3 plus 10. Then separate the 13 like terms. 13 q1, 13 q2, 13 q3. Then add the remaining here. 19, 26 will come, correct? So 26. Got it? Then let's take 13 as common. So q1 plus q2 plus q3 plus 26. So which is equal to 13 into, commonly I am denoting this as q, plus 26. Again I am taking 13 as common. Here where q is equal to, on substituting value. Here for this three values I am taking q as the common value. Okay. So q is equal to q1 plus q2 plus q3. So here 13, if I took common outside, what will be the term inside? Q plus 2. So surely it is a multiple of 13. Surely it is divisible by 13. Therefore, it is a multiple of 13. Hence, a plus b plus c is divisible by 13. Is the wording clear? It is a multiple of 13, no? So, a plus b plus c is divisible by 13. Once again, recollect this problem. When the positive integers a, b and c are divided by 13. So, the respective remainders we are writing. After that, a plus b plus c we need to find. So, a plus b plus c value is here. After finding this, taking the common terms outside. And at last, we are getting 13 into q plus 2. So, in the place of q1, q2 plus q3, we are denoting a common letter q. Okay. So after that we are getting a multiple of 13. Hence a plus b plus c is surely divisible by 13. That's all. Okay, let's see the fifth question now. Okay, dear students, let's listen. The fifth question. prove that square of any integer leaves the remainder either 0 or 1 when divided by 4. Okay, let's see the problem practically by putting some numbers. Okay, prove that the square of any integer, let's think of any integer, 5. Okay. Take the square, 5 square is 25. Just divide it by 4. So 5, 6, 4 are 24, leaving the remainder 1. See, correct only, no? When we taking an integer and if you are taking the square, means it will leaves the remainder 1, 0, otherwise 1 when divided by 4. So think of any another one number, 6. So 6 square is 36. So 36 when divided by 4, 9 4s are 36, we are getting the remainder is 0. So this is the concept. You got this point, I think so. So let's do by using variables. Prove that the square of any integer, so it will be even integer, otherwise odd integer. Two cases may arise. So case 1. Case 1, let the integer be even. Okay, we are taking one integer be even. So what is the general format for writing even integer? 2k or 2k plus 1? 2k. So let x equal to, we are taking, I am taking the integer as x. So x equal to even integer we need to write. So 2k, because 2 is a, since it is a multiple of 2, no? So it is always even. Now we are going to take the square. So x square is equal to 2k the whole square. Now taking the square, 2 square is 4, k square is k square. Okay. So 4 into k square, surely it is divisible by 2. It is the multiple of 4, no? So it is divisible by 2. We will get the remainder 0. Because 4 k square, when we divide it by k, surely we will get the remainder is 0 only. Because 4k square, when we divided by 4, 4 into k square, 4k square, the remainder is 0 only, that way. Okay. So here x square is equal to 4k square. It is a multiple of 4. So therefore, x square leaves remainder. What is the remainder it will leave? 0 or 1? 0. When divided by divided by 4. Got it, students? Okay. What, can you guess the case 2? Let the integer be. What will be the integer? The integer be odd. Odd integer I am taking here. Odd integer. Okay. So x equal to, what is the general format for odd integer? 2k or 2k plus 1? 2k plus 1. So 2k plus 1. Now we need to take the square. So x square is equal to 2k plus 1 the whole square. So a plus b the whole square. What's the formula? A plus b the whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Okay, just substitute here. 2k the whole square plus 2ab plus b square. Got it? So 2 square is 4k square plus 2 2's are 4k plus 1. Now among the first two terms, take any one term, any number outside. So 4, if I am taking outside, 4k we can take, no? So k plus 1 into 4k plus 1 plus 1. So x square. Here also this term is a multiple of 4 and this is the extra term. So that is the remainder. So writing here, therefore x square leaves remainder, how much remainder here? This is, it is a multiple of 4, so it is divisible by 4. And what is the extra term? 1. So what is, 1 is the remainder. So x square leaves remainder 1 when divided by 4. So hence proved the two cases also. Very, very easy problem. The only thing you need to remind, the format for even and the format for odd. Be clear that the format for even is 2k and the format for odd is 2k plus 1. That way you need to write and then square it. Here square term, no need to apply any formula. Here you need to apply the formula a plus b the whole square. After putting the formula, you will get the last step. And after that here, there is no reminder. So reminder is 0. Here it is only one reminder. That reminder is one. So you need to write this and conclude this. Okay, got it, students? Okay, dear students, listen. After the fifth problem, sixth problem, you need to do as homework. This third and fourth. Okay. Now let's see the seventh problem. Find the largest number which divides 1230 and 1926, leaving remainder 12 in each case. The same problem we already dealt some time before. I think so. In the previous class we deal. I think so. Here the previous class we learned, no? Example 2.5. The same method only, that problem. But here leaving reminders, two reminders they gave. But there they given only one reminder. So we need to subtract the same number. The same concept only. Okay, let's see the question. Okay, dear students, listen. Find the largest number. So HCF only we need to find, which divides these two numbers leaving reminder. That reminder we need to neglect. Okay, so since the reminder is 12, the required number, the same format only, the required number is the HCF of, what is the HCF of the minus term? 1230 minus 12 and 1926 minus 12. Okay, that is the HCF of, first you need to subtract the reminders, after that want to find the HCF of the that answer. Okay, so HCF of what will be the answer? 1218 and 1914 will come. Shall we find by Euclid's division lemma, which is the biggest number? 1914. So divided by 1218. So only one time possible. 1218. What will be the remainder? Here 14 means 6. Here 0, 9 and 696. So by Euclid's division algorithm, that big number equal to into 1 plus 696. The remainder is not getting 0. We need to do this continuously. So 1218. So how many times? This is also one time. So 696. So the remainder is here 2. And here also 10 to 2. Here 512. Okay. So here what is the next step? 1218 equal to 696 into 1 plus 522. Okay, let's repeat this. 696. So one time only possible. 2. And what is the remainder? Here 4 and here 774. So write the step for this. 696 equal to 522 into 1 plus 174. Then do one more time. So 522. So 174 into 3, what will be the answer? 12, 21, 22. 4, we are getting a 5, 3, 4, 21, 22, no? So 5, yes, correctly we are getting. So 3 times 522. So at this step we reached the 0 as remainder. So 522 is equal to 174 into 3 plus 0. So what is the, at this step the remainder is equal to 0. So what is the required number? HCF of 1218, 194 equal to 174. Therefore, the required number is equal to 174. That's all. Okay. Once again, recollect this question. Find the largest number which divides these two numbers, leaving reminders. For finding the largest number, this reminder no need. So we need to subtract this. This is same as the example 2.5. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can refer the 2.5 also, the same model only. So HCF of this, then HCF we can find by using Euclid's division algorithm. After finding, we need to write the required number. That HCF is the required number. Okay. Shall we see one theorem? Theorem 3 is there, no? Okay, wait. Let's see, students. There is one theorem. Theorem 3, one line theorem. If a and b are two positive integers with a greater than b, then gcd of a comma b equal to gcd of a minus b comma b. Okay, let's see by putting some numbers in the theorem. Okay, this is the theorem. the condition is A should be greater than B. Correct? Yes. Theorem 3, you should study this, okay? So, you need to take two numbers. Suppose I am taking 12 and B is equal to 6. A should be greater than B. Then GCD of A and B. GCD of 12 and 6. What is the GCD? 12. When divided by up number, you can put 6 2s are 12. Okay. 6 is the GCD. Correct? The first step itself, we are getting the remainder is 0. So, the divisor is, greatest common divisor is 6 only. So, 6. Then, GCD of A minus B, B is equal to GCD of 12 minus 6, 6, which is equal to GCD of 6, 6. So, 6 when divided by 6, 1 is 6. Here also the remainder is 0. So, what is the divisor? 6. So, here we are getting the same answer. So, you got it, students? This is the theorem you need to learn, the condition with the condition. So, three theorems we learned up to this in chapter 2, numbers and sequence. Okay? Up to date portion you need to learn thoroughly. So, here the condition is A greater than B means GCD of A, B surely which is equal to GCD of A minus B, B. So, using this we did one example, and the remaining problems we can deal in the next class. Complete the homework regularly. Okay. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.